हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द वीएलएसआई डिज़ाइन कोर्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द लास्ट टॉपिक इज द डिज़ाइन ऑफ गेट्स यूजिंग मक्स। सो अंडर द आवर मेन चैप्टर एडवांस्ड डिजिटल डिज़ाइन, दिस इज द लास्ट टॉपिक टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर। सो इन अर्लियर सेशंस और लेक्चर्स वी हैव सीन द कॉम्बिनेशन सर्किट एग्जाम्पल्स, sequential circuit examples, synchronous or asynchronous sequential circuits, then the state machines, and previous lectures we have covered the sequence detector using the state machines. So today we are trying to cover a very advanced and important concept of this basic gates implementation using the MUX. Why this we are covering? Because the architecture of FPGA is based on the lookup tables, and lookup table represent the similar functionality of the MUX. So how the mapping of circuitry or Boolean equations happen in the FPGA, that can be easily understood by using this example. So that's what we are trying to cover, this topic, designing of gates using a multiplexers. So let us start. Taken a first example, design a two input AND gate, implement or design it using the 2:1 MUX. So before starting that, try to understand the Boolean equation of AND gate, its truth table of the AND gate, and we'll try to develop it using a MUX. So all of you know the Boolean equation of AND gate is Y is equal to A dot B. So it is a logical ANDing. And as per the truth table, when the both the inputs are logically high, when both the inputs are 1, 1, then output is 1. In other cases, the output is 0. Okay. So for a AND gate, I'm just drawing the symbol. For AND gate, we have two inputs. Input A, input B, and here we are taking output Y. Now to implement AND gate using 2:1 MUX, so for the 2:1 MUX, total how many inputs we have? We have three inputs: input 1, input 2, and select line as a input. It considered as a third input, and only one output. Now to map the two input AND gate and one output, so we can easily map the output, this Y, we can easily map with the output Y. Okay. So for AND gate, let us say I am assigning here output Y. Now, but we have total, for the 2:1 MUX, we have three inputs, but already available inputs with AND gate is only a two input. Now we have to somehow study and analyze these two inputs, how to merge with these three inputs. Now everyone knows the function of MUX. Already we have studied in our combination circuit example video or lecture. So there, depending on your select line, the particular line will connect to the output. So if select line is 0, this will be connected. If select line is 1, this will be connected. So we have to give some input to the select line. Accordingly, we have to manage the input. So before starting that, let us divide the truth table of AND gate. Okay. So how we are dividing? So let us take input A, will do the partition like this, input A and B. So we are dividing it like this. As well, we'll divide truth table in this section. So I am dividing the truth table in two sections, where in half section we are covering the input division, and in half where input A is 0, 0, input A is 1, 1. So what we'll do, this input A will assign to the select line, because select line has only two conditions, either 0 and either 1. So select line we are assigning as input A, because so this will consider as a 0. So this we are going to assign it to the select line, and this also will consider as a logic 1 for the select line. Now if input A is assigned to the select line, so when both the conditions when 0 0, we'll try to analyze this output of the AND gate. So when input or when select line is 0 or when input is 0, A is 0, B is 0, Y is 0, or if you compare whatever value of A, if you see Y is 0, here also 0, so indirectly we can say Y follows input A. This is one condition. So whatever my input A's value is 0, that is also Y value. Whatever A's value is 0, that is also Y value. Or it is nothing but ground, logic 0 or digital 0, we can say. So these are the two conditions, right? So when select line we are giving to the input A, and when input 0 is there at the mux at 0th condition, we can connect here input A, or directly we can connect to the 0, because Y follows the output 0. Okay, now for the remaining outputs of AND gate, it follows the B. Let us see, when input A is 1 and B is 0, output Y is 0. When B is 1, Y also 1. So now here we have selected A as a select line, so because of A as a select line, it will come here. So during select line 1 input, or when select is equal to 1, what Y is follow? Y should follow the B. So this is nothing but the implementation of AND gate using MUX. So we can realize it as, my select line is A, at 0th position we are connecting input again, same input A, at 1th condition, logic 1 condition, we are connecting input B, and output is y. Okay, got it? So like this we can verify the functionality of AND gate using MUX. Now let us validate it. Now if the first condition, I will change the color, now if A is equal to 0, if A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0. So first condition, when A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, because A is 0, it will permanently connect this line to the Y, to the output Y. Okay, so whatever the value of A, it will pass to the Y, so output Y becomes 0. So this verifies the first condition. Yes, this verifies the first condition. Now when input A is 0 and B is 1, so here when B is 1 but input A is 0, but A is connected to the select line, it doesn't affect the whatever the value of B. So again it will pass the value of A will be passed to the output Y, so output Y becomes 0. Now next condition, when A is 1, B is 0. So here A is 1, B is 0. Okay, and because of select line A is 1, now it will connect the second B's output to the Y. So whatever the output available on B is 0, it will pass to the output Y as a 0. Now last condition, when A is 1, B is 1, A is already 1, so B is also, if it is a 1, because of the 2 has to 1 mux, and if it is logic 0, it will connect B line, and output Y follows input of B. whatever the value of B, it will follow. So this is the output of nothing but the AND gate output. So using this structure, we can develop or implement AND gate using 2 has 2 1 marks. Now similarly, one more example, implement a NAND gate using 2 has to 1 marks. So again, we'll follow the same concept. We'll divide the truth table. So we have to give the select line. So we are dividing in such a way that we are doing the partition A input. Okay, then this is my select line. So select line we are assigning to the A. Now we are analyzing. So in this case, if you wanted to implement using only inputs, so why follows? Y is nothing but, we have to analyze the output Y. Y is nothing but the A's complement, A bar. And here Y is nothing but, again, if B is 0, it is complement of B. If it is 1, then here again it is a B bar. Okay. So we can simply design like this. So output here Y. So this is going to connect to our in select line A. Okay. And here second input B during select line is, so this is the implementation of NAND gate using mux. There are again multiple methods. Instead of here also, we can analyze if Y is permanently connected to 1 1, so we can connect it to the VCC also. We can connect it to the logic 1 or VCC permanently instead of using input A's logic. So there are different methods we can implement. In short, we'll take another one example, OR gate using 2 has to 1 marks. Again, we'll divide the table. So everyone knows the OR gate output. OR gate equation is Y is equal to A plus B, that is logical OR, it's not a binary addition. So in case of 1 plus 1, it is logical OR, it's not 1 plus 1 0. That is the basic difference between the logical OR and the binary addition. So whenever input 1, output is 1. So again, we'll divide the table. So permanently we'll collect, we can use the B also as a select line, there is no matter, we can use any input as a select line. So but for simplicity, about better understanding, we'll connect to A as a select line, and we'll try to observe what is Y is follow. So when A is 0 0, so this is 0th condition of select line, this is 1th condition of select line. So when select line is 0, how Y is follow? Y is following the input B. And here Y is following the input A, as well as we can connect it is VCC. So simply we can design OR gate using mux. When select line A is 0, it follows B. So straight away we can connect input OR gate input B here and OR gate input A here, or we can combinely do like this. Okay. So this is the design of two input OR gate using 2 has 2 1 marks. Another one example, we will take a NOR gate implementation using 2 has 2 1 marks. So again, same method, we'll divide it. So this is my select line condition. When it is 0, when it is 1, we have to observe it. So here Y is the complement of input B. So here we can give, in this condition when select line is 0, we are giving it as a B bar, and here it is the complement of input A, or it is connected to the ground, digital ground. Okay, we can connect it to the digital ground. So to implement a NOR gate using 2:1 mux, so when select line is 0, when select line is 0, Y output should connect to the B bar. So here we are connecting B bar, and here it is permanently output all the time. When select line is 1, output Y is always 0. So this will connect to the digital permanently to the logic 0. So this is nothing but implementation of NOR gate using 2:1 mux. So these are the few examples we try to cover like this. We can cover many more examples that can be implemented using mux, and this is very important behavior of mux that can be used to implement various combinational circuit, and because of that only the same concept is implemented in the FPGA architecture. Again, this is the exercise for you people: implement and XOR gate using 2:1 mux. Well, let us complete it. So XOR gate, we'll try to cover it. So again, here we'll divide XOR gate truth table in two sections, similar way, and try to analyze output Y. So here output Y follows the input B, whatever B here, correct? And here it follows the input B's complement. Here input is 0, 1, 1, 0. So the XOR gate can be implemented using, when select line is 0, connect input B, when select line is 1, connect, and select line input should be our input A, get input A. So output Y, and here we are directly connecting at, when select line is 0, we are connecting input B, and at select line is 1, we are connecting it through the inverter, that is B bar. So this is B bar. So this is the implementation of XOR gate using 2:1 mux. Thank you. I hope you have understood this implementation using mux. Keep watching the videos.